Did you know the first woman to run for president was a psychic and a fortune teller? Have you heard about the candidate who received more than 1 million votes while sitting in a federal prison? You think today's elections are bat crazy? Well, you don't know the half of it. History may be written by the winners, but in American presidential politics, history is often shaped by the long shots. The candidates who didn't make it onto the final ballot but still changed how we see America. Long Shots is a series exploring the campaigns of presidential primary losers and the important role these oft-forgotten dreamers played in pushing boundaries, shifting debate, and giving voice to our better angels, and sometimes our demons. In this series, you will hear about the also-rans, the never-was-gonna-win-so-why-even-triers. The primary battles aren't just some sideshow before the main event. They are chock-full of memorable moments. Some long shots leave a mark on society for a generation to come, like Jesse Jackson and his Rainbow Coalition, born in the 1984 primary.
No generation can choose the age or circumstance in which it is born, but through leadership, it can choose to make the age in which it is born an age of enlightenment, an age of jobs, and peace and justice.
Dig deeper and you'll find instigators, pot stirrers, and anti-establishment crusaders. And you'll hear about other voices way ahead of their time, such as Victoria Woodhull, the first woman to run for president in, get this, 1872. Or the affable but divisive Pat Buchanan, who never really had a chance, but who laid the foundation for much of today's scolding conservative discourse.
My friends, we must take back our cities and take back our culture and take back our country.
And how the campaign of Democratic Governor George Wallace, an open segregationist in the Party of Civil Rights, came to an end. These are the stories of America's presidential primary battles, the contest for the most powerful office in the world. I'm Connor Powell, and I'll be your host. For the last decade, I've covered some of the world's most violent conflicts and turbulent international elections as a foreign correspondent. Now I'm back in the U.S., digging into the fascinating tales of campaigns that bring a kaleidoscope of color to our black and white history.
So when can you listen? Long Shots launches Thursday, April 30th. Subscribe now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you listen, and you won't miss an episode. And tell your friends. Because this is the history we all need to know if we have any hope of a saner tomorrow.